कॉन्ट्रैक्टर ए सेवन इज डन ओनली फ्रॉम द व्यू पॉइंट ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर. व्हाट इज की इन दिस अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड नंबर सेवन? Key in accounting standard number 7 is that we are expected to provide for losses. Such loss, what we have to provide should be measured. How do you measure it? How do you know that you have got to provide for loss? When the cost so far incurred plus cost to be incurred to complete the project, if it were to be greater than the contract price, like your carrying amount is greater than recoverable amount, the difference between the two you call it out as impairment loss. Here also we do have the concept like impairment loss. The likely difference between the total cost and the contract price we are expected to provide, and not the entirely we have to provide for loss. Total loss you recognize, and during the currency of the contract some amount of loss they would have already sustained. From the total loss, we have got to deduct the loss that we have already sustained. Only for the difference we have got to provide during the current period. Let me repeat this problem. Problem number 6 is going to tell only about that. Let me repeat. Cost so far incurred plus estimated cost to complete, you have to sum up. The summed value should be compared with contract price. If the summed value is greater than the contract price, then it is a case of loss, overall loss of the project. And in the course of execution of the contract so far, some loss they have already sustained. That amount of loss they should deduct from the total loss. Only for the difference amount they are expected to provide in the books of accounts. Is that clear? That is what we will be taking up in question number 6, the last problem for this November 14 crash course financial reporting. So, one of you please read out. See, we understand that cost to date. What is the cost to date? 120. Further cost. How much? Total 165. Contract price 150. Total loss 15. Don't provide for 15. 2. What is the percentage of completion? How to find out the percentage of completion? We have percentage of completion for which a formula is there. Cost to date divided by cost to date plus further cost, or cost to date divided by total cost. 120 divided by 165 into 100. How many? 72.72. Huh? 73. Okay. Let us not fight. So, what is the revenue recognition? Revenue recognized. 72.73% on 150. 109.10. Revenue recognizes this. Then cost recognized is 72.73 into 165. That is going to be 120. Then loss sustained so far. How much is that? 10.90. What is the total loss? 15. What is further loss to be provided? 4.10. Only this loss is to be provided for. Okay. Now, profit and loss account of highway construction. Revenue 109.10. Cost, how much? 120. Provision 4.10, 124.10, then profit 15. Say all the very best for your examination, and in case of any difficulty, please unsolved problems and all that for which RTP is there for you. You don't have to just really feel that you are not having solution and all that. It is there in RTP. RTP problems only I have taken up for classroom discussion. This is my email ID. So, in case of any difficulty, please put a mail and definitely I will be responding. So, emergency and all that, I will just give my cell number, use it sparingly. Only in case of emergency, make a call. Don't send good morning, good afternoon, happy Deepavali and all that. That's now WhatsApp has come, but anyway, I am just providing you. So, you just (9440-48990). So, any question, give me some time for answering. I will be in a place like taking class and all that. Don't expect immediate reply and all that. So, all the very best. Do well. And in case of any new thing or exciting things, definitely I will be communicating through Facebook. You can just follow me. And anything that is very interesting, definitely I will be posting. Okay. Thank you. All the very best. God bless you. Thank you.